Good morning, folks. It seems like most of you saw yesterday's part 9 of the Catastrophe Cycle series. Much more in the weeks ahead. But this morning, we've got a full slate, so let's go to spaceweathernews.com and find the last day on our star maintaining the silence of the 11-year cycle minimum in which we currently reside. The new coronal hole is visible now on the left. The solar wind at Earth continued to present speed fluctuations, but with a steady decline in the stream density, so they are not producing geomagnetic disruptions. We did get a phi angle shift yesterday, indicating that the departing coronal holes were providing direct sun-to-Earth field pointing, and we said that was the start of the earthquake warning, which luckily came in finally at 6.6, after originally coming in at 6.8, which is in fact twice the strength. We had three interesting rumbles in the U.S. as well, with the Maryland event being the ultra-rare one. It's almost certainly a post-glacial rebound quake, as this part of the continent is in fact slowly sinking down. Similar country names upcoming, but that's about the end of the similarity. Austria's snow records aren't a joke, by the way, but neither are Australian heat records. Austria and Australia, bit more than a few letters apart there. Fun shot of the day comes from Damien Peach, who captured a rock post-collision in the asteroid belt. This happens every single day, if not every hour, in the asteroid belt, but we rarely catch the effects. 10 points, Damien. Awesome run of news starts with exo-oceans and how potentially habitable moons of Jupiter and Saturn likely have strong currents in their oceans and thermal exchange, something critical to microbial life. A team out of China took creativity to a new level and completely erased the annihilating dark matter range from 100 to 300 gigaelectron volts per speed of light squared. That was the prime target, by the way, after CERN failed. In a potentially move-making study on black holes, that's plasmoid or active plasma nucleus to the electric and plasma universe fans, it turns out the event where such massive objects come into being are showing us striking patterns in the photons detected. Such patterns that strain chaotic gravity models of their existence. Next, let's go to Westerland 1, a famous magnetar, and we've got a new study on its multi-outburst activity, something like a superflare or superflares. If you want a fun mental exercise, by the way, look into the current debate in physics whether pulsars turn into magnetars or magnetars turn into pulsars. It's like listening to a chicken versus the egg fight between vegans. Moving on to the top story is major progress on galactic magnetic field modeling has hit the wires. Interestingly, their central field portrayal is actually the inner portions of a torus, helical pinch into the galactic nucleus at the core. Folks, the first university class to ever use our book finished chapter 1 this week. I'm told the students say it is the coolest and easiest to understand textbook they've ever had. The sun, weather, climate, earthquakes, technology, and human health. Get it at otf.cells.com. That's also where you get tickets to Observing the Frontier 2019, which begins in exactly 30 days. We've got your wind maps, followed by shots of our star to close. We'll do this all again tomorrow, right here, but right now it's 4:30 a.m. in the new Valley of the Sun. Eyes open, no fear. Be safe, everyone.